What inspires you to constantly take action in regards to fixing Buffalo?
I guess the successes that you have constantly continue to inspire you to do things because the more things get done, the more excited you get to do more things.
That's a common,
And in a place like Buffalo, I think it's a lot easier for one person to go out and actually make changes and make a difference in a community. And I think that's one of the big attractions for people with Buffalo, rather than being in major metropolis cities. Mm-hmm. You can be in more of a grassroots scenario, working on a lot of different projects, and you don't necessarily need to be making millions of dollars because the cost of living here is so inexpensive. Mm-hmm. As far as all things are considered. And so I think you have a lot of very creative people here.
We do. We really do.
All come together and whose passion kind of drives the momentum of what we're seeing as far as change in Buffalo right now.
That's a really good answer.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So how did Buffalo Rising start?
Buffalo Rising started because I saw a lot of grassroots activity, especially on the west side of Buffalo, Elmwood Avenue, Richmond, and heading westward. And I knew a lot of the people that were kind of instrumental in getting the ball rolling. And I just felt that there were a lot of stories that weren't being told. Also, being a small business owner at the time, I had a retail store on Elmwood Avenue called Thunder Bay for 12 years. Mm-hmm. I felt that there should be more stories about the grassroots, the smaller businesses, the smaller business community. Mm-hmm. That was really kind of the glue for, you know, the artistic communities and the business communities. These smaller groups were really holding together Buffalo. Mm-hmm. And that they were the ones that were really making the difference. And I felt that if I could shine a light on what some of these businesses were doing and kind of steer people in a direction, maybe away from the chains, away from this kind of the status quo, that we could really make a difference. And it actually worked. And we started writing articles on a lot of the smaller underground businesses, and we started driving clientele that maybe previously they hadn't seen in through the front door. And it was just kind of a win-win. It was a win-win for the community that was discovering a lot about their neighborhoods, and it was a win for the businesses in the art community that were finding that this new, a lot of people were rallying around what they were doing. So it was kind of a very exciting time for us.
Thank you. What is your master project for Buffalo? I know that you have multiple projects going on. Right? You seem like you're the multiple project kind of guy. Like,
well, you know, you wake up every day and you put on a different hat and you get excited about different things. And, we had talked before about this. It's not necessarily that, you know, I'm not a hockey player, but I'm passionate that Buffalo should have outdoor skating rinks. And by kind of leading an effort alongside younger hockey players who don't necessarily know how to navigate the ropes they need to navigate in order to make things happen. For me, I feel that I can kind of lend my expertise and my passion to them so that they can take what they're passionate about and actually make it come to fruition. Same with the film community. I'm working with the film community right now these are the people who not just we have the film commission up here, and we've got Squeaky Wheel, but you know, there's that kind of center ground where it's like the everyday makers, the everyday directors, the people who live